could be a witness to your majesty and your love. May it remind us that you are always watching and listening from your throne above. May your presence and your beauty be found in every note. May the words that are sung reach the hearts of your people so they will draw closer to you. May your spirit guide us through every moment, that we might be the instruments of your peace and proclaim glory, your glory, with gratitude.
had when they set up the meeting. This piece is very special. If you watched the coronation a few weeks ago, you heard this in Westminster Abbey. If you saw the royal wedding in 1981, you saw Princess Diana process to this. If you saw the last royal wedding with Princess Kate, you saw her process to this piece. It is a magnificent piece, and one of the things that I'm challenged with and excited about in this grand choir piece is a dialogue. So the scripture says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. Jerusalem is huge. It's enormous. You can imagine yourself in a magnanimous space. We're singing about a magnanimous space. But the choir actually divides up into two choirs. Jerusalem is a city that is a unity within itself. So two choirs are going to sing, and in that third movement, they come together again at unity. And then they pray together for the peace of Jerusalem. And finally, peace be within thy walls. Each of us in Jerusalem will have, it says, and plenteousness within thy palaces. Each of us in Jerusalem will have our own palace.
Yeah.
So now think about plenteousness in your palace. See, we don't just have primaries, we learn what we're singing about. So when you think about plenteousness, think of that ocean and that ocean and that ocean, and you're going to put all of those oceans into your palace. That's what plenteousness is. So if you want to shout, here it is.
Thank you.
know the day of Pentecost, that they heard all this noise in the house, the tongues of fire dropping, there was a mighty rushing wind. Outside, the folks said, they must be crazy. They must be drunk. Peter said in his wisdom, he said, no, this is that which the prophet Joel spoke about. In the last days, our old men will dream dreams along with our old women. Our young men and women shall prophesy.
Well.
So God, we just thank you for this offer. We want to take a moment just to thank you because you brought them through perilous times.
Yes.
They lost us for a period. But heaven gained some good old soldiers coming home. You brought them through a pandemic.
Yeah.
You brought them through family dying. Churches being torn apart. The thing that we love to do most, Lord, was put to a halt.
Yeah.
And so today we say thank you for bringing us back together. Lord, you brought us back. We say, mighty and long life. We say, thank you for bringing us back. We thank you for Robert. Thank you for his beloveds. Thank you for his beauty, father, brother, thank you because you've endowed them one more time with your spirit. You've given them power on high. And as they waited these 3 long years in the upper room, once again, you've proven yourself that you would not forsake us. You would not abandon us. You would not leave us. But you would fill us with your spirit one more time. So God, as they move forth from this day, give them a double anointing. Give them something special to deliver this city from the bondages of sin and death. Give them the power, the anointing, the first ring that will deliver this city. That their voices will be heard, that the Pope will hear them, that as they go before kings and queens and sing the songs of Zion in strange lands, Lord, bless them. And now bless your people who have come here today, not for the form or the fashion of it, but to be encouraged. So inspire them, keep them, affirm them, strengthen them. Give them peace in their own homes and everything that they poured out today, Lord, pour back in them. We will see you again, Lord. And now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power both now and ever. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst them and remain with them always. And all of God's people.